Hello everybody, my name is Peter Koutnyy and today I will speak how to think during our chess game and what's the right thinking process. So welcome here and I hope you will enjoy this video. So first position and my first questions to you. What do you think? Is this position mostly likely to be strategical position or tactical position? Because this is the most important question and maybe this is the best way how to improve your chess. Okay, if we are going to watch position where we can find lots of weaknesses, lots of piece contacts, lots of threats and weak kings. Let's speak about position tactically. So let's play tactically. So we have to find threats and we have to do calculation. This is a different between strategical position where we have to think about our war piece when time is not so important and we have time to improve our position. First position is absolutely tactical position where we have to strike our opponent and we have to go and to find the most attacking move. So what do you think here black will play? And of course we should find a move where we will attack something. So maybe we are speaking about move to take on f3 or we are speaking about to attack a white queen. Everything what makes a threat, it's not a bad move in such of kind dispositions, but the best move here is to take on f3 by black's rook. So let's take it and here white is lost. Well done to everybody who thought that this position is tactical position and we need to do something fast. We need to do something hard and we need to push this position. Okay, for example, yes, of course, if white is taking by g pawn is a check on h3 and mate on d1. And that's a different not in a chess style, but this is a different how to play position at a strategically and slowly, at b fast, pushed and go for win. And this is important to split these two types of thinking and to use the right thinking in the right position. I hope you agree with me that this rook is hard to take and for this reason black lost. Let's go for another position and the same question. Why to move and what do you think? Is this position good to play slowly or is this position good to play fast to push your opponent? So if you believe that this position is more mostly likely to be strategical position, you are wrong. This position is still open and black's king is a weak king. So if our opponent has a weak king, let's shoot him, let's go forward and let's do something and use your advantage. That's your chance to win a game, that's your chance to beat your opponent. And of course, 5 seconds, what do you think white will play here? Of course, white will take on g6 and at the end is checkmate. But of course, everything else just here to play slowly is a huge mistake. If you understand what I like to tell you and if you will hear my advice, just think if this position is most strategically or tactical position, because here of course is checkmate, here exactly and black lost. Well done and let's go to another position. Here black to move and my question is, what do you think? Is this position good to play slowly or is this position good to play fast? And of course, this is the right question to you and to get the right feeling, because the difference between strong and a weaker chess player is how they are think, what kind of moves they are looking for. And you know, here black is winning if he is able to see that this position is tactical position. White king is a weak king without no escapes rooms and you need to see 2-3 moves and of course to do little bit of calculation, because if bishop to c5, b3, and now you are taking on g3. This move looks like a bomb, like a great move. You know, you are going to exchange your queen for knight. But at the end, of course, is a checkmate on h8. Rook to h8 is a mate. But the first move, the first step, how to play this position correctly, it was to decide if we have to play fast or if we have time for slowly maneuvering. Okay, let's see another position. And here, it's white to move. And what do you think? I think it will not be hard questions to you. Is this position more strategical or more tactical? Yes, of course, you can see the different. This position is not open. There is no fight or no touch between pieces. And looks like this position has time to improve or to do something to find a plan. And in such of this position, the best plan is to find your worst placed piece and to improve it. And that's exactly what Akiba Rubinstein played here. He found it that here he has three good pieces. It's two bishops and a d5 queen and three not well placed pieces, rooks and knights. Now he need to work, or you need to work hard and to find the best square for these pieces, nothing else. Just improve your position because you are playing this position in strategical style. And you need, and you have time. You need to improve your position. Here to play tactical is a mistake because this position, it's not calling for a fight. This position is calling for improving. And what's the most important lesson from this position is to improve your worst placed piece. So knight is going to a3 and c4. I hope you believe that this knight is well placed on c4. And right now, white has only two bad pieces. Rooks on f1 and rook on h1. So the last goal is to improve these two pieces. It's a simple chess, it's a good chess, and this is the best way how to improve your chess. Just go there and have the right thinking. In some position you need to play fast and attack, and in some position you need to improve your position. And for example, here at the end, of course, watch what's happened. Knight, if you remember, it was on c2, now it's on d6, and this is the best white piece. This is a signal of great chess player because he found it a problem. Knight on c2, a bad piece. Knight on d6, a winning piece, because now black is losing pawn and at the end is losing. It was a great example how to see a difference between two types of positions. Let's go for another one. And here, what do you think about this position? White is Bobby Fischer and black is Bernard Zuckerman. And yes, this position looks like to be more tactical, but it's an endgame. And the golden rule in endgame is to play by all your pieces. So I mean by all, not only by rook and queen, but by the last not active piece, and watch what's happened. And this is a lesson. You know, this position is not calling for tactical idea. This position is calling for strategical thinking, and maybe this example will help you to understand what you are looking for, which moves are good for you and which moves are working for you well. For example, here. So my question is, what do you think white will play here? And watch what's happened, because this is amazing. White is playing endgame, and wow, he improved the last not active piece, maybe the most important piece in the endgame, and of course he won soon or later because he has more material. This is a great story of chess. Two types of position, tactical when we have to play fast or strategical, when we have to play slowly and maybe endgame, when we have to play by all our pieces. And that's an that's a cool idea how to understand chess and how to play good chess. I hope you enjoyed this video. If yes, feel free and press like and give me follow and give me comment and give me a like and see our another YouTube chess videos coming soon. Last example, black to move. Of course, this position, it's not tactical position because it's not open. I don't see any threats, I don't see any fight between pieces or pawns. So let's speak about strategical position. What to play here? What's the worst black's piece? And where to place this piece? And of course, it's your time. You have 5 seconds to find the best move, and I hope you will find it, because this is the last example of this video and your last chance. And yes, this piece is the best, is the worst, is the terrible piece. Of course, it's a French defense bishop, and the best move is to go to a4. At least you are stopping move a4, and maybe white like to improve his bishop, and you are going to attacking the biggest white weakness on c2. And well done to everybody who saw this move. Well done to everybody who think that in a strategical position we need to improve our pieces, and in tactical position we need to go fast. We need to start fight and we need to attack everything. Every attacking move is nearly good move in tactical position, because who is attacking is not defending, and who is attacking is a winning. And I hope that my words was okay to you. You enjoyed this video, and I will see you soon. So guys, thank you very much for your time, and see you soon. Bye bye.